Abundance Stock Advisors. Let's make money.
Hello friends, welcome to Abundance Stock Advisors. To keep getting notifications on all these videos, please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon. If you are a serious stock market investor, think of joining our YouTube channel. It's a game changer in the stock market advisory industry. To know the benefits of joining a channel, watch our channel joining video, which is coming up here at the top as a suggestion video. And the link can be found in the video description below. Now, in this video, we are going to talk about different types of stock brokers that are available in India, the advantages and disadvantages of opening an account with each broker type, how these brokers operate, what to watch out in them, and how much do they actually charge for a buy-sell transaction. At the end of the video, you will be able to select the right stock broker for your needs. And also towards the end of the video, we have some motivation for you. So stay tuned. Now before we start, let's understand who a stockbroker is. Well, a stockbroker is an entity that allows you to buy and sell a financial instrument that is traded on the stock exchange. These instruments could be shares, commodities, currencies, etc. But let's restrict our discussion to only shares here. Now, there are two types of stockbrokers in India, a full service broker and a discount broker. They both serve the purpose of buying and selling shares and are governed by the rules and regulations of Securities and Exchange Board of India or SEBI. First, let's get into the details of a discount broker. Now, discount brokers, as the name suggests, are cheaper to engage than a full service broker and do not offer advices or any kind of premium services. Some popular discount brokers in India are Zerodha, Samco, etc. So, if you know what stocks you want to buy and you can make investment decisions on your own, then a discount broker is a better choice for you, as they will charge you a flat fee for your transaction rather than a percentage of the transaction amount that a full service broker will charge. So let's see what a discount broker can actually offer you. One, lower cost. Now this lower cost is usually the result of lower commissions in terms of flat brokerage costs. Example, if you are buying 500 quantities of a stock, which is for rupees 1000, the total transaction amount is say 5 lakhs. Now a discount broker will charge you a flat fee of 20 rupees only for this transaction. A full service broker, on the contrary, will charge you a percentage, let's say 0.5% on the entire transaction amount of 5 lakhs. So this comes to 2500 rupees as brokerage. Two, unbiased service. Now, because they don't offer advice, discount brokers have no vested interest in trying to sell you any particular stock. Three, access to information. Established discount brokers offer extensive educational materials at their offices or on their websites. Now, what to watch out for in them? One, lack of guidance. Now, because you've chosen a discount broker, do not expect any guidance. You must know as much as possible about your personal goals and needs. The responsibility for conducting adequate research to make good stock selections is totally on you. So if you are knowledgeable, it may work in your favor, as there is no interference. Two, hidden fees. Discount brokers may boast about their lower commissions, but commissions aren't their only way of making money. Many discount brokers charge extra for stuff such as issuing a stock certificate or maybe mailing a statement. So watch out for these. Second, lack of customer service. As most of them are internet brokerage firms, they may not have physical offices that you can visit to resolve your queries. So you are mostly dependent on their call centers or email communications for getting any of your issues resolved. Before making a choice, it is very important to find out about their customer service capabilities. So friends, to sum it up, the biggest advantage of a discount broker, apart from the relatively small transaction fee, is that the broker does not have any vested interest in what you buy or sell. Thus, there is no conflict of interest. Now, let's go into the details of a full service broker. Now, as the name suggests, they offer as many services as possible to the investor who opens an account with them. You will also have an account executive assigned to your account, also known as an authorized person or AP, who is registered with the exchanges and who will help you achieve your financial goals through timely and pertinent guidance. So if you are new to the stock market or can't provide time for your own research, then a full service broker is your choice to make. Some popular brokers in this category are Motilal Oswal, Angel Broking, ProfitMart Securities, etc. Now let's see what a full service broker can offer you. One, offer guidance and advice. The greatest distinction between full service brokers and discount brokers is the personal attention that you receive from your account executive. So you disclose much information about your finances and your financial goals to the account executive. And the account executive is there to make recommendations about stocks and funds that are maybe hopefully suitable for you. Yeah. Next, provide access to research. Now these full service brokers can give you access to their investment research department, which can give you in-depth information and analysis about any particular company. This is valuable, friends. This is valuable. Help you achieve your investment objectives. A good executive will know about your financial goal, your risk appetite, and time horizon for achieving your goals, and will work towards creating and implementing strategies to help you accomplish your financial goals. Next, make investment decisions on your behalf. Now, what happens? Lot of us do not want to be bothered when it comes to investment decisions due to the fear of making a bad decision or lack of time maybe. Now, these full service brokers can actually make decisions for your account with your authorization. This service usually is termed as Portfolio Management Service or PMS and may have additional costs for managing the account. And these costs may vary from broker to broker. Now, what to watch out for in these brokers? One, higher costs. Now, this higher cost is usually the result of charging a percentage of the transaction amount as a brokerage than a fixed amount which a discount broker charges. Example, if you are buying a stock future for, let's say, ABC stock at 1000 rupees with a lot size of 500, then the total transaction amount is 5 lakh. So, if a full service broker charges a brokerage of 0.002%, then the total brokerage amount will be 100 rupees as against to a flat 20 rupees brokerage offered by a discount broker. Yeah. Focus on sales. the account executive or the AP are sales people. Though they treat you really well, they do it out of selfish interest as they get commission on the revenue that they generate from your account. So watch out. Excessive trading. If you have a PMS account, make sure you review it every 7 to 10 days to check if any excessive trading is being done, maybe only to just generate brokerage. If you see any such activity, you better ask for justification, because this activity is made with sole purpose of generating brokerage. So you should never tolerate it. So before you choose your broker, understand where you stand in terms of the knowledge of the stock market, the amount of time you can invest to acquire the knowledge, and your financial goals. Always remember that you make money in stock markets by selecting the right stocks and not by selecting the right broker. Some motivation for you. Make money, use money to make more money. Repeat. Friends, money attracts money. Rich go on becoming richer, isn't it? We've all seen that. It's because the rich utilize their money well to make more money. So let your money work for you. Don't let it sit idle. Invest well. To keep learning and to keep yourself updated, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon. Please like and share this video. In the comment section, let us know if you've had any bad experiences with your broker so that we all can learn from each other. Until then, happy investing. Jai Hind.